Hello, and welcome to BIS3's course on using OBIEE. In this video, I will guide you through creating a key performance indicator. A KPI is a tool that can help evaluate the success of reaching or the failure to reach a target revenue. First, make sure you are logged into the OBIEE server. The address of your server, as well as your username and password, should be provided by your administrator. Now that you are at the home screen, click New for a drop-down menu of options. Under the Performance Management section, choose KPI. Following this will be a list of subject areas. We are going to use the Sample Sales Light option. As the top of this page indicates, there are 5 steps to completing the KPI. The first step is to complete the general properties. Fill in an appropriate description that explains the KPI's purpose, such as a KPI guided by BIS3. Below the description should be 2 areas, actual value and target value. These 2 values are the foundation of our KPI. Click the arrow next to actual value to select the appropriate value. Expand the base facts folder and select revenue. Repeat this process for the target value option, but select target revenue under the base facts folder. Next, we are going to format our data to look more like revenue. Click the pencil icon to edit the formatting. Change the first option to currency, select United States dollar as the currency symbol, and change the negative formatting to a minus sign. The next option enables trending. Trending allows comparisons of data between an amount of time, whether it's per year, quarter, or month. Choose the per name month option. The tolerance percentage will show an alert for a positive or negative change between the current time block and the previous one. It will only show the positive or negative trending if it is greater than or equal to this percentage. Click Next to continue to the dimensionality section. In this section, we will define a KPI value for each dimension that we select. This section is important for when we create a KPI watch list. We want to include an entire hierarchy of information instead of limiting ourselves to just a few dimensions. Click the Add button at the bottom, expand the Time folder, and add the Time hierarchy as a dimension. You should now see Time hierarchy under the Dimensions column on the left, and Is prompted under the Value column on the right. Is prompted means that the end user is allowed to control the value instead of being pinned to just one that we might specify here. Add the Office hierarchy under the Offices folder, along with the Products hierarchy under the Products folder. Click Next to continue to the States section. When we generate the KPI, we will receive a status based on how the revenue compares to the target revenue. This section allows us to control the status labels and when we would like to see a certain status returned. Change the OK threshold to 90, and the critical threshold to 75. This way, we get a green label if our revenue is 90% of our target revenue. We will get a red label if our revenue is less than 75% of our target revenue. We will get a yellow label for anything in between 75 and 90%. If there is no data returned, then we will get no status. We can add a state by checking the checkbox next to Show Advanced Properties in the right corner. If you decide to add a state, don't forget to change the name, color, and icon of the new state so it is not confused with another state. Click Next to continue to the Related Document section. In this section, you can add a catalog or a link to the KPI. We can skip this section and continue to the Custom Attribute section. In this section, you can add a label and formula to your KPI to customize it to your liking. We can skip this section as well and finalize our KPI by clicking Finish. Create a new folder called KPI and save the file under this folder. I'm going to call mine My First KPI. Thank you for watching and following along with this BIS3 tutorial on how to create a KPI.